Now, if you're into your gaming PC handheld consoles, which are getting just so much better lately, this is the Anya Neo 2S that I have. Fantastic performance with its integrated graphics, the Radeon 7080M. For what it does a really good job. But if you want to double that performance, then of course you've got eGPUs. And I have this one here, which is called the Gaming and AI Box. Now, it's from a company called SGW Zone. And why it's a little different from other GPU setups is, well, you can upgrade this particular model here. Now, they did send this out to me, full disclosure, this is a sponsored video here. I'll be testing it out and I'll show you what it can actually do. So to work with mini PCs, gaming handhelds like this one right here, as long as you do have Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4, or USB 4.0, which this gaming handheld console does have. So inside this configuration they sent out to me, I've got the Radeon RX 6600M. It's got 8 GB of dedicated graphics. It is an 80 watt part, and you could even get an RTX 3070 model, and later on in the future they'll have upgrades because inside is an MXM card that you can slot out and upgrade. You can't do that with competing models. Now, the power supply within it is very powerful, 240 watts, thanks to Gantech that it does use, and it is only 766 grams, which is impressive when you look at the size of this here. There's even a screen on the front of it that we can customize, which I'll be showing you in this video. I'll show you how to set it up and what you can expect performance-wise. So this is what will be included. We've got our power cable there, and EU plug, of course, for me here in Europe, and our cables. So that is a Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4, USB 4 cable, so Type-C to Type-C. Now, I just wanted to point out that this is an early prototype, so there will be some imperfections you may see, just a little couple of things that will come up, because this is a 3D printed outer shell that they've just sent with this early unit here, so I can take a look at it, test it out, and give you this video here. So we've got a power button at the front here, we have two USB 3.0 ports, and then our Thunderbolt ports. Now, using one of them, there's one that supports 80 watts, so I can just have a single cable connected to it. Now, both of them are the 40 gigabits per second. So that's USB 4.0 or the Thunderbolt 3, Thunderbolt 4 speeds. And look at the size of this too. So what I'm going to be using and connecting this to is the Anya Neo 2S. Now this here, you can see the size-wise, is a thinner, of course, but it's a lot longer than we have with this external GPU. And this external GPU is doubling the performance of it. And this, of course, has the Ryzen 7. It's got the 7840U in it. And that's what I'll be using. So I can double that performance, connecting it up to this. And this only has the Radeon 6600M in here. And if you get another version later on, they're gonna have with the RTX 3070. That's gonna be a little bit quicker. And later on with the 40 series 2 of GPU. So on the back here, we have an intake for rubber feet. And you'll see here, this is the exit vent. So all of the hot air is gonna be blown out of there. And on the back, we do have two HDMI 2.0 ports, another USB 3.0, and DisplayPort 1.4. So with those three video outs, you can run three displays. We have a vent here, some screws on the back of it. And this is the power in for that GaN power supply, which is 240 watts, which is a pretty good feat. Incredible, really, to consider how small it is. It's taking up about that much room there. And now at the top of it here, we do have a screen that you can use to display things like your CPU temperature, the fan, RPM, and whatnot. And to me, it does not look like a difficult task at all to be able to slot out this GPU for those future upgrades later on. So there are, I can see some screws here that you need to remove. There's one there, one there. We've got our plug here, you have to pull that off, and this is the plug for the fan too that goes in here. So once that is done, you remove the cooler on this. Once that is off, you'll then be able to slot out that MXM card. Now, I'm gonna keep it all intact here because I want it to be just how it left the factory so we can see exactly later on what the thermals are like for the Radeon 6600M that this is currently using. So this is my setup there with the Neo 2S. Of course, it is using an integrated GPU normally, and that's the 780M, which by far at the moment, Intel hasn't caught up yet, is the best you can get for integrated graphics. However, now plugged into its USB 4.0 Type-C port, I've got that Thunderbolt 3 cable. That is going into our eGPU, doubling my performance now. And with that single cable, that is all I need with this USB 4.0 port, because it is powering it too with that power delivery up to the 80 watts. And you can see it is charging. I don't have any problems. So great that I just need that single cable. And now with the HDMI cable connected to it, I have that using the video out there for it. And that's going into a capture card. And I'll show you and run you through now some benchmarks of what you can expect performance-wise from this eGPU. Okay, so this is what it would look like when you first do get it set up. You'll see that the Radeon RX 6600M is now listed here. Now, I installed the drivers because you've got to do that first. And I do have the latest AMD drivers. Get them from their website. You run that. The Adrenalin you can see I'm running here is version 23.10.2. And here, first, I'll just show you with GPU Z there that it's the 780M graphics. Now, this is running off the shared memory that I have installed. And while it is quite fast here, this is the 7,500 mega transitions. This is a little bit, well, it's still good performance for integrated graphics, but not quite as good as this here we do have now, which is our eGPU. Now, the eGPU is using DDR6 Samsung RAM. We've got 8 gigabytes of it here, and you can see a little bit of the information of it here if you're interested in that. Okay, so it does have the units it uses is 64. Now, if you do want something a little bit more powerful, look out for that RTX 3070 version, sorry. That does have a little bit more in terms of power and whatnot that we're going to get out of it compared to this unit right here. Now, I will be monitoring those temperatures. We'll see what it does get up to when we are gaming. But just one little benchmark I wanted to show you here first, because this, I think, is very important to show you the kind of increase we are getting. So with Time Spy, I'm just going to run this synthetic benchmark because there's no point in me showing you any more because it's going to be the same story here. Double the performance here, actually over double. So the graphics score, while yes, this card, if it's not via an eGPU setup using Thunderbolt 3, could actually get around about the 7,000 mark, but still 6,240 for our graphics score compared to the integrated graphics that the Neo 2S does come with. You can see, look at that difference. I mean, that is huge. That's well over double the performance there with the graphics, even though, yeah, the 6600M is not exactly a powerful GPU. It's pretty much quite low end, but you see it's going to make a bit of a difference now in gaming. So first up, I'm going to play a little bit here of Starfield, and I'm going to play it with the 780M first and then move over to our eGPU so you can see that performance increase. So with the low preset, and there's a lot of NPCs around, that 780M is faring quite well. Look at this, around, well, it was 60 before, but now 48, 52 frames per second. But it is only 720p, and it is the low preset that I'm using, which is highly recommended. Wouldn't want to go any higher with that, with such a demanding game like this. And here in Neo, of course, there is a lot to render. We have all the smoke, the steam, all those NPCs, the lights, and everything. And now I'll go over now to the eGPU and we'll check on the performance gain we're going to get. With Starfield, I've kept everything the same. So it is still the low quality preset. The only thing I've changed is the resolution. We can play now at 1080p. And look at this huge jump in the frame rate. Well, not that massive, but it just looks so much better too at 1080p. So you can see that it's a lot more playable, more steady frame rate too. And running about here with such a detailed, busy area, still over most of the time averaging, yes, over 60 frames per second. And if I start a fight here with security, where are they? Oh, that's not a security guy. Over here, it is still, as you can see, quite playable. Yeah, the frame does dip down a little bit now and then, but the main thing is we're gaining just so much performance now with our Thunderbolt eGPU setup. Diablo 4, this I do have set to the lowest preset setting, so there's nothing else I'm adjusting, I'm only changing that. And again, the resolution is the 720p that I'm going to go with now with the 780M. This again is faring quite well, the frame rate, but it does have some big frame dips when you load in certain areas to 75. And it doesn't look good at all, really. I think on the lowest preset, this looks terrible, but integrated graphics and the Neo 2S can handle this game. So I'll just find an area where there's a few enemies before moving over to our SGW zone external GPU. So, okay, some big frame dips there right now.
but it's still very, very playable around 70 frames per second. Now look at the huge difference we have in our frame rate. It's 135 frames per second, but not only that, the visuals. I put it up to 1080p and it's on the high preset and it can play the game just fine. Again, you're gonna see some of those frame dips, but this is just a massive improvement in the, not only performance, but the quality. The game is just so much better here. And of course, this is straight out from the HDMI port into my capture card. So there's no performance loss. The only performance loss is, of course, that overhead we have with the Thunderbolt. The Last of Us. Now, this is a very demanding game, but I've got it set to 1080p with our RX 6600M. And you can see, very playable. This is on the lower setting, so maybe it might actually be better, this game, because it's so demanding, probably to even run it at something like 720p. Because it's only around 45 frames per second, but this is a good looking result here, still compared to the integrated graphics with that 780M. Now, it's not just for gaming too. This eGPU can accelerate, of course, like 3D CAD work, but video editing too. I have noticed here, this is one of my reviews. Now, it is quite basic. There's no advanced editing going on. The timeline is smooth. Now, I normally don't run with this kind of scaling. I've got it set to 300% at the moment with Windows. And I've just done this to make things a little bit clearer for the video for anyone watching on mobiles. You can see with the playback that it's not quite 100%. It's a little bit slow, I've noticed. So it's occasionally dropping frames and is a little bit slow, but this is so much better than the integrated graphics, which does tend to choke when I do edit larger videos such as this. And the export times will be a little bit faster. I'm gonna export this now at the 4K preset. So it's just about to finish up now. The bar is at 100%, taking over 20 minutes now and 35 seconds. So the encoding time is a little long. There we go, 20 minutes, 38 seconds. But what it does do definitely is boost that editing performance. I have found that the playback and the timeline is so much smoother than using the integrated graphics. Finally, fan noise and thermal. So I've seen it get up to 78 degrees Celsius, and the fan, while you definitely do hear it, it sounds a little bit like a gaming laptop when it is under full load and working hard, pulling the full 80 watts. So here's a sample of it. So recapping here, one of the favorite things that I like about this is it acts also as a dock too. So I've got my mouse, my keyboard plugged into it, my external monitor, and I can take my handheld gaming PC, plug it into it, and then I've got a desktop set up. It just makes it a lot easier there, and you double your GPU performance over even the best integrated graphics, which right now is that Radeon 7080M. This is going to still be twice as fast, as I did point out there. When you look at those 3D Mark scores, at least, and the gaming, just more fluid. You can game at 1080p and just even up those visual settings there too, which is great. Now, I'm really looking forward to an RTX 3070 model, which does have a higher power limit. This one is currently the top that it runs at and pulls is 80 watts, that RX 6600M. But I hope to see later on with future models that we will have, say, an RTX 4060, an RTX 4070 would be really good to get some amazing performance out of it. But as it stands, doubling your performance, I still think is fantastic. And I love the fact that it's got a 240 watt GaN power supply in this. So it's compact, yet the output of it is really good. And the screen on the top of it that you can customize with information like fan RPMs, temperatures and various other things is really handy to have. Now, the links that are in the description of this video, do check those out because that's where you'll find that information on the availability and pricing of this unit for both the RX 6600M model and the RTX 3070 model, which will also be coming out. So thanks a lot for watching my hands-on with the SGW Zone Gaming and AI Box.